my God! Yes! Hey, everybody! We did it! Wow!
How about that intro?
All right, so that I just have to say, hey, first of all, hi. I'm Daniel Levine, and I am the artistic director of a theater here in Ridgefield, Connecticut, called A.C.T. of Connecticut. And this is Bryan Perri. Bryan Perri is the resident music supervisor of A.C.T. of Connecticut. Bryan was also the conductor of Wicked on Broadway for, what, nearly a decade, I think?
That About he, a yeah. decade, yeah.
And is currently, well, not so currently, but currently, the music director and conductor of Alanis Morissette's musical Jagged Little Pill, which of course is on a bit of a hiatus right now.
Intermission, a long intermission.
A long intermission. That's what we like to say. Tonight is obviously the premiere of our new live stream called Happy Hour. Yay! It's opening night.
Not many opening nights lately, so we're loving this one.
Yes, yeah. And we're using a new platform, a new streaming thing called, what is it called? It's called StreamYard. And it's
we're very nervous
about it. I've been having nightmares about the thing, and I've been waking up in cold sweats about the thing. So anyhow, if it's a little messy, just bear with us. But we'll deal with that in a little bit. Before we introduce Derek and Kathryn, our first guests for this thing, I want to bring in Katie Diamond. Katie Diamond is the executive director of ACT. Again, Brian's the music supervisor. I am the artistic director. Katie is the executive director. And the three of us are the founders of ACT of Connecticut. Here is Katie Diamond. Hey!
Hi, Katie!
How are you?
Here I am in the bedroom.
Are you excited?
I am excited. This is so fun.
This is going to be fun. What everybody should know is that obviously ACT is, we've closed our doors right now. Katie lives in Ridgefield, like Bryan and I do. Katie is about a mile down the road in her house, and Bryan and I are in Ridgefield in our house. And just so everybody's clear, about social distancing, why are Dan and Bryan together? We are married. We have been self-quarantining. And is that what you call it? Self-quarantining?
Self-quarantining, social distancing, yeah. Isolation. I don't know. We're being good and doing our part.
Yes, it's been a month. Almost. But it's going well. So I think that before we, before we bring in Kathryn Gallagher, yes!
Our amazing special guest.
And Derek Klena, some of you guys might not know what ACT of Connecticut is, our theater. And so we wanted to give you a little background as to what we do here. So Bryan, you've got your screen ready. I'm going to share the screen. Here we go. Again, this is all brand new territory. Here we go. All right. So wait, hang on. Yes. Okay. So ACT of Connecticut is a not-for-profit professional theater located here in beautiful Ridgefield, Connecticut. We produce and present 4 shows each season. We are an equity theater, just a little over an hour outside of New York City. So because of that, we're able to employ incredible Broadway talent and designers, directors, choreographers. We also have a thriving artistic community here in Fairfield County. And so we have a pretty great mix of local and Broadway talent. We also have a very active conservatory program for young aspiring performers. We at ACT of Connecticut believe that theater matters, and we are committed to bringing art and theater to our community. Let me see if I did that right. Did I do it right? Hold on. Yay!
Hey, we showed pictures on a live stream.
Okay,
I was nervous about that.
Yeah. All right. Now, obviously, like all theaters, we have closed our doors temporarily. We had to cancel the last 2 productions.
Sadly, yes.
Yep. Nickel Mines and Freaky Friday. Today was meant to be our annual gala, actually. Katie, all that planning, right?
Oh my gosh, all that planning. We had such an amazing team of people who are working on it, and but we'll do it. We'll do it again.
We will have another gala. Wait, what's it? Yes, we've closed our doors and everything, but we are attempting, we're really working very, very hard at ACT to continue to entertain you, entertain our audiences, our patrons, to engage. Everybody needs a little entertainment,
yeah,
especially.
Just generally be adorable in Ridgefield. You know? That's what we're trying to do.
Exactly. Yeah. So careful when you hit the desk, it's going to make that mic vibrate and I'll go crazy.
Surprise.
Just like we're at the theater, right, Katie?
Just like.
Yeah. But we actually started live stream 3 weeks ago now. Mm-hmm. We did a great live stream with our friend Stephen Schwartz. Stephen, of course, is the composer of Wicked, of Pippin, of Godspell. He is a good friend of ours. He's one of our artistic advisors at A.C.T. of Connecticut. He actually lives right down the street from us, also here in Ridgefield, with his beautiful wife, Carol.
He's a great supporter of us, and we're always very grateful to him.
Yeah, he's amazing. And believe it or not, close to 60,000 people watched that live stream. 3,000 watched it live, and by that weekend, 60,000 people watched it. That was about 3.5 weeks ago. And that part of the reason why that was so popular was because the New York Times picked that one up, and also our friends at Music Theater International, MTI, helped promote that. So we expect that this one's going to be a little bit more intimate, but I bet by Sunday, thousands of people will have watched this. It was a great one. Aside from the Stephen Schwartz live stream, we have another live stream series, actually two more live stream series. One for our younger audience members. It is called Story Time. We partnered with a great bookstore here in town called Books on the Common. Our ACT alum are reading stories to our younger patrons, our younger audience members.
It's so cool. Support independent bookstores right now.
Yes, please.
They're everything.
Yep. And it is it's a great live stream. And then, of course, tonight is our premiere of our Happy Hour. Happy Hour is our very, very first one. And we're really, really excited about that. Isn't this live stream thing, this StreamYard thing, cool?
It's wild. We're just like going with it, getting used to the rhythm of the whole thing.
It's really good. Cool. Now, all right, so we thought long and hard about the vibe that we wanted to, portray.
Yeah, we like a vibe, clearly, from our picture that you saw. We're real, real vibey.
Yep.
There's like sequins going on, lots of sequins. Yep. I'm, all this is like what, rock star.
This is, Katie, is that what you wore to Jagged Little Pill opening?
Yeah, it is.
This is what I wore to Jagged Little Pill opening. Yeah.
So,
we thought it should be like, oh, let's make it sophisticated, and nobody really has a reason to dress up nowadays, so let's try to make it like that. But then as we were, as we were thinking about the whole thing, we thought like, no, I think that it should be, a little bit more casual, we felt. So instead of this picture right there. So that's what we, that's how we thought we wanted to sort of portray the evening. That's how we thought that
the way it should go. Yeah, that's what we normally are. We're super glam and high fashion at ACT.
Yeah, but like we just felt like that probably wasn't the way to go for this. It's just not the right time. So what we decided to do instead was to. Katie, so you almost made it. Oh my God. Katie, we need to rehearse more with you.
I know.
We can't afford dressers right now.
It was close. We almost made it.
My kids can dress.
Where's my hat? Hold on a second.
Oh, quick, get the hat. Hold on.
All right. This is how we actually wanted to do it. Yeah. We want to be like cash, and we wanted to be super
much better.
It's better, right?
Yeah.
Like, who cares? Like, we can dress up for an opening night another time. Yeah. Anyhow, that was fun. We did a quick change.
Yay! This is how we've been pretty much the entire social distancing quarantine time. Robes and sweats and all the stuff. And
yeah.
You know what? I'm not sorry.
No, sorry, not sorry. Yeah. All right. So I think it's time to get started.
I think so, too.
Happy hour. So we are so, so grateful and thrilled that Kathryn Gallagher and Derek Klena are our first guests for this live stream happy hour, which is going to be either an every week or every other week live stream. Kathryn Gallagher, of course, works with Bryan at Jagged Little Pill. She originated the role of Bella. She is unbelievable in this show. If you have not seen Jagged Little Pill yet, when it reopens, you must. It's life-changing. I think about it all the time. We'll talk a little bit about Jagged Little Pill. But Kathryn was also in the, 2015 revival of Spring Awakening. And that was literally one of the best
productions. Oh, profound. Yeah. Amazing.
She's also a gifted and amazing songwriter. But she can tell you all this herself. We are so happy to bring to our live stream Kathryn Gallagher. Hey!
Yay! I miss you, Kathryn. It's so good to see your face.
Oh, it's so good to see you. I miss you so much.
I miss you too. I mean it.
He's gonna cry. That was like a cry choke. Just FYI, yeah. Everybody.
Well, you know, we make a family, you yeah. know, when we do our stuff, and you know, we have daily relationships, and I miss them. So, Kathryn, where are you right now? You're actually not too far away.
I'm close. I'm in Kent, Connecticut. So I'm like right up the road.
That's so funny. And so that's just where you've been camping out for how long now?
75 years.
Well, that's what it feels like. I know.
5 weeks now.
Okay. And you're not alone right now, right? You're with friends. You're what?
Yeah. My brother's here, which is great. So I was quarantining with some friends in the beginning, and we had like a nice little dance party, which was a blast. And then now it's just me and my bro.
All right. You holding up okay? Everybody's safe and healthy by you?
Everybody is safe and healthy. I mean, it's so remote up here. Like we're so surrounded. You can't see our neighbors. We're just fully in the woods. And so it doesn't feel like anything's different. It just kind of feels like we're here for Christmas, but it's a really long Christmas.
Right. Very extended Christmas without the presents.
Yeah. Well, thank you for, thanks for being a part of our first live stream. I also want to bring in a very good friend of ours, of our theater, Derek Klena. Derek, of course, originated the role of Nick in Jagged Little Pill. He's like flawless in the show. Derek, many of you might have seen him in Wicked on Broadway, Anastasia on Broadway, Bridges of Madison County.
He's done
on
a Broadway. Lot of stuff. He's yeah. done well he's, for himself.
Yeah, he's up and coming, I would say. He's already up. Please welcome Derek Klena. Hey! Oh! Wait,
okay. It's so cold in quarantine.
I know, wait, so tell us where you are. Tell us, are you in a robe right now?
Of course I am. Oh I had God, to dress up it. For you guys.
I thought it was like a shawl, collar sweater sort of situation.
No, it's just a little dark. But no, it's definitely a robe.
All right, I'm into it. So where are you, Derek?
I am in Southern California right now with my family. West Covina, right. California, the pride and joy of the San Gabriel Valley.
Yes, yes. But
big deal.
More importantly, get closer to the camera for a moment.
Oh, what?
You are growing a mustache.
Oh, my God, Derek. Oh, get boy. Rid of that.
I love it. I think it's great.
I don't understand the question.
Yeah. Sorry, you're right. That was my bad.
I've always had the ability and the strength to grow such a stash, so I took advantage of the time alone to do so.
Yes, exactly right, because it's not a Nick Healy mustache necessarily. Right?
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Wait, what? Kathryn?
How's your special patch, Derek?
What? Okay. So during Jagged, obviously I played like an 18-year-old and I had to be clean shaven every show. And when it did start to grow out, I noticed like this little spot that, see, it's gotten better, Kathryn. But before it was like a full on gap. Like I didn't grow any hair. But
oh, really?
Your baby's growing up. Look at it. It's coming in.
Aww. There's no penciling action going on there. It's actually
no.
Happening. Okay. Oh, there might be.
So
I touched on a nerve.
Hey, Derek. I asked Derek, just the audience, just so yes. you know, I asked Derek this earlier today, if it was okay to talk about this. But actually, Derek, you did have Corona, and you were sick. Can you tell us how you're feeling? Can you tell us about that? Yeah, we're curious to know.
Yeah. So I got the Corona. Like the first week of March, I was actually one of the first, or I was the first member of our cast to be diagnosed or testing positive for Corona. And luckily I feel great now. I'm back to 100%, but it was, I think it was a gift and a curse to kind of get it first before a lot of the craziness kind of ensued. We still didn't know much about it at the time when I had it. It just felt like, you know, the first day it felt like I was having like severe allergies. And then for the next few days, I had a fever between like 99 and 101. It was kind of like a mild fever, but the aches were really bad. But I was lucky that it kind of stayed between kind of like a fever and a cold. It never really got to that bronchitis pneumonia place where like my chest was infected, luckily enough. I never had the trouble breathing. But I have to say, like one of the weird parts of it was I lost all sense of like smell and taste, which no one really started talking about it until like a couple weeks in. But that was probably one of the most consistent side effects or symptoms that I had experienced when I had talked to friends and people that were popping up and they tested positive. So that was kind of the ones that went under the radar for a bit. But yeah, it's crazy. Luckily, I feel great now. I've been
how long did it take, Derek? How long did it take till you felt better?
I started, my fever broke after about 4 days, and then my taste and smell went for about another week. Wow. Yeah, it was pretty gnarly. And then I had like spurts of feeling like chills and feverish symptoms, but my temperature never went back up for about a week or so. And then even after my taste and smell started to come back, it didn't come back fully for probably 2 to 3 weeks after.
Wow.
It took a while to regenerate.
I'm just so curious, because this has been coming up a lot with people we've talked to. Did your taste and smell come right back, or was it just like sort of slowly, like you?
No, because I was like boiling essential oils. I was trying to like I was trying to like fill my face with smells. And at first, my smell came back a little bit. My taste was funky for a while. It took probably like a solid 2 weeks after I started to regain my senses for like me to taste and smell things fully again. So it was definitely like a regenerative process. Like, I don't know. It did take a while though. It was bizarre. Well, all of a sudden, like all alcohol and like tequila tasted like olive juice.
Oh my
God. It was so weird.
Well, we're glad that you're better. I do want to point out that when I made you full on the screen, I can still see what everybody's doing. So Katie, I did see you reach for that drink when
this one? Is that what you mean? What was you mean the second one?
Oh, double fisting. Nice.
Where are your children?
Just in case.
Katie, where are your kids?
They're downstairs. I'm hiding. I told you I'm hiding in my bedroom.
I got it.
Okay. I like your wallpaper.
So Katie and I got to go to opening, saw Jagged Little Pill opening night with our friends Allison Stockel and Caroline Kellen, two of our best friends. I got to tell you, opening night was magical. And I mean, I don't know, the audience went crazy and the show is just so fantastic. I think because we have two of the stars here, Derek and Kathryn, and Bryan, of course, is the music director and the conductor. I thought it would be interesting for you guys to maybe talk a little bit about briefly about the sort of the creation of the thing, the rehearsal period, Alanis Morissette. Why don't you take it?
Well, so, you know, as we talk about a lot at ACT, new musicals undergo a very sort of long involved process to get to Broadway, if we even get to Broadway. So, you know, we do these little workshops and things. Actually, Derek and I were one of the few people who did the very original 29-hour reading. And the story was very, very different. How did Nick's story end in the...
Nick ended in prison, I believe.
Right.
You were saying we learned from prison, in a, right? Yeah, we quickly learned that maybe that's not the most uplifting ending, to have Nick just sitting in his jail cell with a lighter, just kind of going back and forth.
I lived, I learned. Yeah.
We set up so many scenarios where Nick is just like sad sitting in the jail cell, like the only one not participating, and everyone else is just clapping on stage together. Yeah, just a different dark turn for Nick. Yeah.
Crazy. I love where your totally ended up.
Yes, me too. It's good. Sorry, do you want to keep going, Bryan?
Oh no. And then Kathryn, when did you first sort of join? Because Bella was actually not in the first drafts of the show. So when did you come in?
I came in, my reps wrote to me and they were like, hey, we have this general ensemble call for Jagged Little Pill, but we know you sent us that email 3 months ago when you heard about the reading saying how badly you wanted to do it. So if you want to go in for this, like, you know, here's when it is. There's still no part for you, but they say that there's a lot of moments that pop out of the ensemble if you want to go in for it. And I was like, sure, of course I do. 100% is Alanis going to be there. Diablo Cody, say no more, I'm there. And then I showed up, I did the general call with you, Bryan.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah,
I remember you walked in with your guitar, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then I got called back for one with Diane, I think. It was you, Diane, and Mia, if I remember correctly. And that was when the Bella sides came through and it was like featured ensemble, but it was like a full scene. And that was August of 2017. Well, and I was filming you at the time, so I wasn't even technically available, but I was like, I got to do it. So then you was kind enough to write me out of two episodes to let me do the
free. You were kind enough to forget me.
Yeah, and yeah. Right.
My character went to grief counseling camp.
That's
that is awesome. Okay,
you mentioned Mia, right?
Mm-hmm.
And Mia is going to be is one of our guest directors for next season here at ACT. I love her, and I can't wait for her to work. For us.
You're watching. Awesome. Hi, Mia.
Hi, Mia. Cool. Yeah. Do you want to continue with this?
Sure. I would love to know what your top three favorite moments or things that you just miss about our daily life at Jaggy Little Pill, or even if you just have one, Derek.
Well, this moment right here, I miss seeing you guys.
Yeah,
I know.
Well done.
This is true. Like, Kathryn and I have dressing rooms adjacent to each other, and we literally are waving through a window at each other. I miss our family. I miss coming to work and getting to deliver that show to an audience that needs it now more than ever. I mean, totally. Every day. I think that, like, one of the reasons I love theater and why it's different than any other medium of entertainment is the collaborative process. Like Bryan was saying, it takes years to put on these musicals and build them from the ground up. And one of the best parts is growing as a family and having this instant group of friends and collaborators. And over that process, you get so close. So I miss our crew, our amazing cast. I miss you guys. And yeah, I think that's what I miss most.
Miss you too. Kathryn, what's one thing you miss?
I think besides the show and the beautiful healing connective, beautiful moments of live theater, I miss backstage shenanigans. Like, I miss like goofing off and like being an idiot and like those moments of reprieve from like the intensity of the show, because they kept me sane.
Yeah. Yeah. Awesome. Well, we miss you guys. I miss performing the show, and you know, hopefully we'll be back sooner than later.
You will. You will. Yeah. All right, cool. That was, yeah. So, I mean, I just urge everybody watching, if you have not seen Jagged Little Pill, when it is back up and running, you must see it. It's such an important piece of theater. And it was like kind of life-changing for me. So, we got a lot of emails from our ACT patrons, from our audiences, and some of Derek and Kathryn's fans. And you guys have some serious fans.
No joke.
Serious fans. I mean, like, kind of like, if you don't ask this question, I'm going to be very, yeah. Anyhow, we thought we would take it, we wanted to take this a little bit further. So a lot of your fans were asking for production photos. They wanted to see you guys in various shows. And we wanted to take that a step further. And show some pictures of all of us sort of before we became the theater professionals that we are. So we call this segment Broadway Bound.
Question mark. I'm waiting for this.
Don't you think that's cute, though? Broadway Bound.
Okay. I love it. Dude, your really production quality on this, I'm actually like super blown away. That opening, these effects,
the opening,
nailing it,
good,
guys,
right?
Nailing it.
It's like
what? It was amazing.
The opening is good. I mean, it's good, right?
It's awesome.
So I just have to say, I worked about 9 hours on that thing, on that 30-second thing. Yeah,
you did that, Daniel. That's pretty impressive.
Oh yeah, yeah. I do some video. I've learned how to do video work for ACT of Connecticut, right, Katie?
You have. You've been very good at it.
All right. So where were we? Okay. All so right. Yeah. So we call this segment, as I said a minute ago, Broadway Bums. And what we want to do is show some pictures of all of us before we were on Broadway and before we were the professionals that we are. So I think that we should start at the very beginning. I've seen on Facebook that that the senior pictures are going around right now, the senior and high school pictures.
But you're not supposed to do it, apparently, because credit cards, banks, and
I was going to put mine, and he wouldn't let me.
Because fraud.
Stick in the mud.
Hackers. Yeah, it's a thing.
But anyhow, let's start with some baby pictures, yes. Okay? So why don't we, let's see who is first. Who is this little cutie? Oh, it's Derek.
Derek, are you in a sink?
Look at that. Yeah.
All right.
Of course. That's right. That's where I like to bathe, Brian.
I still do. It's fine.
Yeah. Derek, I see that you're.
I said, Mama, put me in the sink.
And you're touching the water with your little thumb.
Yeah, it wasn't warm yet.
So cute. All right, who is next? Oh, Kathryn has Minnie Mouse.
Are you a Disney fan?
No.
Is that Spider-Man foot I see?
It was Halloween. Jamie was Spider-Man. And I was, no, it's funny. My parents didn't really let me watch a lot of Disney. They were like, I watched all Annie. I watched on repeat. I dressed up as Annie every day when I was 4 years old. Like, it was all the classic musicals. There was no princesses really in the house.
You're so cute. You look the same.
I really do.
You do.
You look the same. All right, who's next? Oh, Katie Diamond. Katie, it looks like you're dressed up as Holly Hobby.
And maybe going to the bathroom.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
I know. Like, so do you remember that picture?
Nope.
What house is that?
I don't remember anything.
What house is that?
But I do believe that that's me because my mother said it is. So
is that not your childhood home?
I don't know. No, I don't think so. That must be my grandmother's house.
Oh, it's cute. Yeah. All right, who's next? Oh,
Daniel.
Levine.
Is that Daniel? Yeah.
That is me. I look like an alien. My head is oval. My mother clearly gave me a bowl cut. Blunt bangs. And I have a little shoulder going on. Hey.
Well, look at those eyes. How cute are those eyes?
All right, good. Who's next? Oh,
there he is.
Brian.
I used to be cute.
He's so cute. His leg seems to be stuck on the bicycle.
I wasn't athletic as a kid. Couldn't get on it.
Amazing. Is that everybody for the baby
picture? That's for the baby picture.
All right, great. So that went really well, and I did well with the computer. Great. So next is the high school, our high school graduation pictures, right? So do you want to go to the first one? Mm-hmm. Great. So first we have, you guys are going to die when you see this. So first we have, Derek.
Hemp necklaces. I wore hemp necklaces.
Look at that puka necklace and my Abercrombie and my Abercrombie collared shirt
and feathered hair.
That what hair,
yeah. Dude, that hair was a statement piece.
Yeah, obvi. Yeah. Next.
All right, who's next?
Oh,
all in white. Such an angel.
Oh, you look the same. I mean, that was probably what year did you graduate high school?
2011.
So yeah,
very good.
So cute. So cute. All look at that smile. My God.
Smile's the same. Next.
Who's next? Oh!
Wait, everybody just do the pose.
Oh.
Same. So embarrassing.
Katie, I feel like your hair has gotten more blonde as you've aged.
You know, it's funny. My children have noticed that too.
It's natural.
That's amazing.
All right. Next.
Next. I can't with that.
There it is.
So, oh, God. Yep. So
are those slippers? What are you wearing?
So this was 1980. No, this was 1990. So it was the thing to do was to wear a cardigan and a mock turtleneck. And then those socks probably went up to my thighs. And then yes, they were like slipper/black shoe. I don't
and
know.
Some
like
sort
a
of
loafer
square on the floor.
Yes, they told me to sit on the laminate. Yeah. So I sat on the laminate.
Really fun.
I can't. Why don't we move that picture along? Yep.
I love it.
Oh, yeah. Brian.
Ready for anything.
But Brian, that's not a senior picture, I don't think.
It's what we found. It's close.
No.
Very cute. I love it. All right, wait, we have more pictures, right?
Okay, so here's.
This is a good one. So this is us in theater and shows when we were not yet professionals. So this is us in shows in high school or younger. So first we have. Oh, Derek!
Oh, my God.
Tin Man, explain.
I was just, I was, you know, rusted. So that was me just, you know, committing. At a young age, I've always been committing at the fullest.
Well, the makeup on the jaw is pretty great.
Oh, yeah. No, it was at a children's theater I grew up doing. Met two in Southern California.
It's really cool.
And yeah, their productions were awesome. I grew up doing two shows a year with them from when I was like 6 to 17. So
wow.
Long history. Look at that hair too, man.
Just intense.
And foreshadowing, right?
Yeah,
very good.
Yeah, all right,
good.
There you go.
Who's next?
Now this
Kathryn, it seems that you're it's
saucy
Chicago.
I was 15, which is so inappropriate. if you zoom in, you can see a little Ben Platt in the background.
Where?
I can't zoom in any farther.
So zoom in.
Oh, like, I see him. He's on the left.
Other here? One. Yeah, other
oh,
one.
Here?
Yep, that's Benny.
Oh my gosh.
So yeah, I was 15. I was Velma Kelly, and that was like our production photo for the show.
Where did you go to high school?
I went to high school. This was my after school theater program called the Adderley School. But I went to Harvard Westlake in LA.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Seriously, that's production values.
Seriously.
And I've looked at this picture a lot when I, you know, put it in this program, and I'm seeing new things every time. It's pretty great. Yeah. It's pretty great. All right, who's next? Katie Diamond as Dorothy in The Wizard
of Oz. Everybody did The Wizard of Oz in high school. I don't know why.
Katie, you look like 24.
Stop, I was 12. I think I turned 13 during the show.
I just wanted to point out the difference between Derek's Tin Man and this Tin Man costume, that is.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fair enough.
I hope that guy's not watching and he's going to send us a hate email. Katie, where did you do this show?
At Village Theater.
In Seattle.
In Seattle.
Yay, yeah. Village Theater. Yay, yes. Fifth Avenue Theater. Yay, Seattle Theater. We love Seattle.
And I had a Toto. I had a real dog that was about 40 pounds. I'm not kidding. It was so heavy. And I remember one time, like, we had these stairs, and I would go through the audience and then go up onto the stage, like, on these stairs that were on either side of the stage. And I remember carrying that dog and falling up the stairs, and my shins were bloody, like, all bloody. And I just kept going.
Amazing. You're a pro. You are a true pro. All right, who's next? I can't with that.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I can't. So, all right, this was Conrad Birdie in Bye Bye Birdie.
I knew it.
Believe it or not, you got to go down. Believe it or not, I was a senior in high school and I looked like I was 11. That I don't even know what to say about, but I know that my mother rented that costume from me from a Halloween store.
Your mother loved you very much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if you look at the boots, if you scroll down, the boots, yep, those were black, like, boots from, like, my uncle, and my mother spray painted them gold. And I will say that I was the butchest Conrad Birdie that Framingham North High School has ever seen.
Is that true?
No.
Okay, very good.
Not at all. What is next? Oh. Yeah.
When you see a guy. So this is actually college, and I'm smoking a candy cigarette, and this is my star turn. I believe I played gambler number 75 in my college production of Guys and Dolls. I was really good.
That's Michael Harrington.
That is Michael Harrington. Oh. Michael Harrington's
watching. Oh. Who's Michael Harrington married to?
Elena Shadow. Yes. If anybody knows our friends, Elena.
Do you know Elena?
Yeah,
we love that.
Yeah.
All right. Wait, Bridges, are there more production photos?
Well, we have our professional photos.
So now we're gonna go. This is it's going well, right?
Very well.
Katie, is this going well?
So
well?
It's going so well.
All right. Good. Good.
Yeah.
Good. We got to move it along, though, right?
Yeah.
All right. So so next are like the real production photos. This is actually what the fans asked for. They wanted to see pictures of Wicked and Jagged Little Pill. So let's look at that. So first we have Derek in Wicked.
Broadway debut, right, Derek?
That was my Broadway debut. It was also my first Broadway show that I ever saw. So it was kind of a cool full circle moment to be a part of it 10 years later. What?
That was awesome. And we did it together. I love that.
Yeah.
What'd you say, Kathryn?
Not when you were in it. Seeing it when you were in it was not the first time you saw a Broadway show.
No. I saw it. And then 10 years later, I got to be in it. Thank you, Kathryn, for clearing that up for us.
We need just clarity.
Great. Next. Oh, Derek, Anastasia.
Brilliant.
Derek, what was, did you love being in the show?
I did love being in that show. I grew up with the movie. So, and that was one of the, you know, animated characters that if they ever made a Broadway show out of it, that was like a dream of mine to get to do. And I just happened to be the right age when it was all kind of happening. And yeah, it was a dream come true. It was amazing.
And who is that you're starring opposite?
Christy Altomare. We actually played boyfriend and girlfriend in Carrie, which was my first job in the city.
That was your New York debut. Yeah, so. I saw that. I loved it.
Yeah, right. It was fun.
Who do we have next?
All right.
Oh, I love this. Yeah. Kathryn Gallagher was in, oops, what happened? Was in Spring Awakening, as I said earlier, the revival, which was like one of the most amazing productions. Kathryn, tell us a little bit about that.
So this was, I mean, that revival was such a dream come true for me. It started out in a 99 seat theater in LA. No dreams of Broadway, no promise, no thoughts. It was not going anywhere. It was a fun thing to do on the weekends. And then all of a sudden, a year later, we were opening on Broadway. So that was like a really wild time. And that was a time when I like wasn't planning on doing theater professionally. I wasn't like, it just kind of happened. And so that moment is from Mama Who Bore Me, the reprise. I think we're signing. I need to remember what that sign is for. For me, Mama, who gave me, I believe. Is that what that
happened? Kathryn, you did that with such authority. Were you the dance captain?
Excuse me, yes, I was.
I just wanted to make sure. And also, there is a recent Tony winner in that show, in that picture, right?
Miss Ally Stroker, my love.
Yeah.
Incredible. Incredible.
That was such a good production. Kathryn, that was so good.
It was truly one of the best times in my life. I will never, I mean, it was life changing for me in a big way.
What's next for Kathryn? Oh, Jagged Little Pill.
I love this picture.
We do happy musicals.
Yeah, I was gonna say, yeah.
I have to say that Elizabeth Stanley is in the white coat. She plays
Mary Jane,
and she's also unbelievable in the show. It's kind of like the best cast that I've ever seen. I love it so much. And you're so good in it, Kathryn and Derek.
Very special.
So good.
Next we have Katie Diamond.
Jersey Boys. That's Katie in the center. Katie, tell us about your experience with Jersey Boys.
Oh, it's just such a fun show to do. Oh my gosh. It's like being in a, different than Jagged Little Pill, but same kind of like, feels like you're in a concert every night. You're singing like this crazy pop music, you know?
You're in the center. Your center stage
where you belong.
I'm a really fun black girl, yeah.
Duh.
It was fun.
All right, next.
Wait. Oh shoot, go back. I saw Katie and Jersey Boys.
Did you?
Yeah. Where did I see you?
Before we really knew each other.
Before we knew each other, but where were we?
We were in Atlanta.
Yep, Atlanta.
Yeah.
I just happened randomly saw her in it.
Yeah.
You were real good.
We worked together.
All right, let's go to the next, which I'm embarrassed about.
No, okay. This is great.
So this is me and Les Mis.
So for those of you that don't know, by the way, a lot of people know Dan as the artistic director of A.C.T., a director, a famous movie director, all these things. But Dan was an actor and still is an actor on Broadway for a very long time and very successful. So this is back in Les Mis.
Les Mis, this is 1995. That's me and D.B. Bonds and David Joseph Sberg and Andy Redeker. Those are our barricade outfits. I was very young. This was my first big Broadway show. And we had to grow our hair out. Like we had to all have mullets because they didn't want us wearing wigs.
They have leave-in conditioner back then? It looks like it.
Wait, that's your real hair?
That's right. My hair.
Doesn't his hair look
that is and remarkable.
Right.
Yeah. It's amazing.
Yeah. Amazing. Yeah. All right. All right. Next, here's another amazing Dan memory.
Oh God. So.
Stop.
So I played Mary Sunshine in Chicago for many, many years.
Oh my God.
Yes. Yeah.
So when I first met Dan, he played Mary Sunshine. I was like, okay, I knew what it was, but I didn't absorb what it was. So if you don't know, Mary Sunshine sings soprano. It's unreal, like what these humans who do this can do. And so Dan and I were doing like a concert together once and he sang it. So we're rehearsing at, you know, a piano here. And all of a sudden this flawless diva like soprano comes out of him. And I'm just like, oh my, it's wild what sounds he can make up there.
Everybody that has ever seen me do Chicago says that I look just like my mother. I'm sure my mother, Judy Levine, I'm sure she's right now,
Judy.
Emailing all of her friends about he's on. Yeah. So that was my Chicago time. Let's move on. Get away from
it. Amazing. Amazing.
Right. So here
I am in Wicked, right?
Yeah, Wicked. Nobody cares too much about the music director. So I don't have fancy production photos. So I have people take secret photos.
And that's a cool picture though.
It's cool because you got the green in the back and like, it.
Yeah.
Mike shows off my nose job really well, so I'm very happy with that. Okay. This is me pretending to be a rock star.
Jagged Little Pill.
That's me on stage with Jagged Little Pill. The band is watching. I miss the band so much. You guys are awesome. It's so fun to see you in a picture like that.
So good in that. All right, what's next?
That's our last picture.
Oh, is that everything?
Yep.
Yay, that was called Broadway Bound.
Very good. Right,
good. Wait, so now I have to remove Bryan from the stream. Wait, nope.
Technology, break for technology.
Please. All right, I did it. Okay, so the next, all right, now, oh, I wanted to ask Derek. Derek, did you always know that you wanted to be an actor when you were younger?
No, I mean, it was always a dream of mine, but you never really think it's attainable up until, it wasn't, it really, I didn't think of it as like a career. It was always a dream. I didn't really think it could be a career until I was in like high school, college. So it was later on for me that I was like, I really love this. I really like want to do this for a living. And yeah, but I grew up doing it from a young age and always aspired to be that. But,
yeah. So Kathryn, Kathryn comes from a pretty famous household, I would say. I don't think that everybody knows this, but Kathryn's father is one of my favorite actors. It's Peter Gallagher. Hey!
Look at that guy.
Peter Gallagher is Kathryn's father. I mean, look at how you guys look alike. It's kind of crazy.
Can I make that face?
Just make it. Yeah. It's good.
Yeah.
It's good. So I'm curious, was your, did your dad like want you to go into theater? Did he discourage you? Tell us about that.
Well, he really wanted me to, he would always say you only have one chance to be a kid. And so his biggest thing for me was that I fully experienced my childhood. I didn't start working early. I had very different ideas of what I was going to be doing. Since I was like 3 years old, I've been, you know, singing and dancing everywhere. And then when we moved to LA when I was 11 years old, because he was doing the OC. And so when we first got there was when I started really writing songs and learning how to play guitar. And once I learned how to do that, I was like, oh, now this is exactly what I want to do forever for the rest of time. And so I kept sort of writing songs and started going into the studio around like 12 and 13. And they still thought that was kind of harmless. But then when I was 13 years old, I saw an audition online for Mitchie in Camp Rock, the Demi Lovato role. And I said to my parents, I was like, you guys, you got to let me do it. It's me. It's happening. And they were like, no. So I slammed the door, ran into my room and picked up my guitar and wrote this song called and after that, my dad was like, we'll let you audition, but there's no promises. And then he kind of realized like it was going to happen either way. And so they hopped on and have since been the most supportive parents. I mean, I could ever even imagine.
Was he at opening night of Jagged Little Pill? Because I was looking for him. I didn't see him.
He was filming. So he took a red eye and he landed like an hour before or something and left like first thing in the morning. I mean, he really was like, he would not miss it for all the, when he took his job, he was like, I will take it, but I have to be available on December 5th.
How nice.
He's the best dad ever. It's like so insane.
He's also like an, I love him. He's such an incredible actor.
It is helpful to work on like auditions with him because he's very smart about scripts and character. And yeah. So he's been very, very helpful to me.
So you talked about that. I mentioned earlier that you're an amazing songwriter and some of your songs and music have been featured on TV series and
all sorts of things, all different things. Mediums.
Kathryn, do you think that you could sing a song for us? I know that you have your guitar nearby. Could you sing a song for us?
This whole thing?
Ridgefield is grateful.
You're hardly prepared.
Of course I can. I actually wrote this like a week ago. So it's amazing. A little fresh, but I've been writing so much that I figure like I might as well. No one's actually heard this, which is crazy. Oh my God, cool.
You get a debut of a song. That's great. Thank you, Kathryn.
Okay. Let's see if I remember it. Oh, it goes like this. My therapist calls it healing. All this processing and reliving. And my mother wonders when I'll get over it. Well, my father don't ask questions. He says, thank God you got out at the last second. My brother's good at listening, but I'll bet he's sick of it. And I still have questions. It's the most lethal weapon. Holding nights for answers. Begging for sleep is my new anthem. wake up in a panic. Your name on my lips, cold sweat, no breath in. I'd do anything to forget. You never been at my workplace. Never is too soon, babe, to see your face. And I don't know if you've ever told me the truth. Well, I hate you because I trusted. For the first time, I gave you my best. And I started to think maybe you did too. Still have questions. It's the most lethal weapon. Holding nights for ransom. Begging for sleep is my new anthem. I wake up in a panic. Your name on my lips. Cold sweat, no breath. I'd do anything to forget. Just apologize to my brother. I didn't know when I was bleeding. I played onto so many others. I wanna say sorry to my best friend. Where's your murder when she said she was worried? Instead of hiding all the things you did. Sorry to my mama for the sleepless nights. And to my father for never saying he was right. And at the end of the day, they stood by my side. Pull back the curtains till I open my eyes. And God, it's bright. But I still have questions. It's the most lethal weapon. Holding nights for answer. Begging for sleep is my new anthem. I wake up in a panic. Your name on my lips. Cold sweat, no breath in. I'd do anything to forget. My therapist calls it healing.
Yay! Oh my God, amazing.
Another super uplifting song.
I mean, we are where we are. Honor it. So thank you for sharing that, Kathryn. That means so much to us and for debuting that. That's gorgeous.
That's amazing.
So grateful. So many beautiful comments from everybody.
You're wicked talented.
Oh, thank you so much. You must be
Oh my God, that was amazing.
It was amazing. We're lucky. So, so now on something just a little lighter, we asked everybody to bring their three must-have quarantine items.
Oh.
So, yes. So, everybody, you know, we all have these different... Dan's leaving for a moment, and he's gonna have to do his separately, and you'll see why in just a moment. We asked everybody to bring the three things that they cannot be in quarantine or social isolation or social distancing without. We've all got our sort of creature comforts that we need. And so here comes Dan with his first one.
Okay, my first must-have item is a little dog that I have. Oh my God, this is Ivy. And Ivy is
Ivy.
And Ivy is now 2.5 years old.
2.5 years old. We love her. She's a lot, but she's the lot, best. Yes.
But she's really cute. Ivy, say hi. Over here.
Hi, Ivy.
There we go.
So I cannot live without Ivy. I will say that like when I'm at the theater all the time, which I'm not now, we have a dog sitter every day for Ivy. Yep. So we don't
Hi Lena.
Hi Lena. So we don't see her a lot. But now we see her a lot.
but it's okay.
But it's great.
It's totally
fine. Say goodbye.
Okay, bye, Ivy.
Bye.
Thank you so much. All right.
So that's Ivy.
Okay. Moving on to Derek. Do you have your three quarantine
items? Me? Oh man. Well, you know, the part that's the most fun and sometimes drives you crazy about being quarantined is you are sharing spaces with large amounts of people. I love my wife and my family, but you know, everyone needs a little time for themselves. So having these in are nice. Your headphones. Love you, Mom. Uh-huh. and then, you know, they, you know, a little vitamin D, stepping outside, getting some fresh air is a must during this time. Of course, 6 to 20 feet apart, 30 feet apart.
Always.
So having a good flippy floppy for indoor and outdoor use has been essential for me. And then a little vitamin D never hurt anybody.
Actual
vitamin D.
All right,
because you know, being inside and not getting that natural vitamin D makes you grumpy. So
excellent. Thank you, Derek. I hope people take that to heart. Katie, what are yours?
Oh, okay. Well, first of all, where'd it go? Oh, here it is. Hold on. Coffee.
Oh,
and
wait.
This is my cup.
Uh-huh.
I love Mom.
Okay.
All right, then. Okay, this, my kids don't know about this. It's a secret that now they're going to know about.
They know now, yeah.
I color.
Oh, me too. I love color.
And I hide this so my kids don't ruin it.
Too late.
And here's one of my pictures.
You are a really good color.
Wow, that's good.
A+. I stole the lines.
Yeah, very good.
My pen. So my pen's in my coloring book. And then my other thing that I'm obsessed with during this quarantine is baking. So cake. Coffee, coloring, and cake.
Sometimes Katie leaves us baked goods at the head of our driveway and we just go get them and they're real good. Thank you, Katie, for sharing. All right, Dan is here with his second item.
Here's my second item, and it is this little rabbit.
We rescue bunnies now.
Look at this little rabbit. It is a white rabbit. Black ears. And we don't name our animals. We don't name our, well, we'll show you in a minute, but we don't name our rabbits. Mm-hmm. But she lives with her sister. She's a rescue. We saved her from a life of
torture. Prostitution.
But she's very cute. She's more like a cat than a rabbit. But we love her. And she lives in a little mansion outside.
Yes.
A little heated mansion outside with her sister. And so this is the rabbit. Okay, bye, rabbit.
Okay, very good. Okay, my necessary items are as follows. Derek, I've never understood you so much in my life. Noise-canceling headphones. Like, beyond necessary. Shuts everything out. And,
just
you know,
a minute of peace.
A good book. I'm reading this book by accident. It's about a pandemic, but what are you going to do? But it's excellent, and it's super long. That. And then while I'm reading the book, my other must-have item is whiskey. Yay! We love
it.
So thanks for that. And now, we're just waiting for Dan has another amazing third item. And this item actually, as he's getting this, benefits not just us, but actually kind of benefits all of Ridgefield. Well, and it benefits Katie actually. So okay, come on in, Dan.
Okay, so I got my third item, and that is, hold on. Move the chair. This little chicken.
We have chickens. We have 30 chickens. That's a silky.
This is a white silky. And she is she's broody right now, which means that she's like attached to her eggs. But we've got 30 chickens, Ryan and I. We raise chickens. We've got a lot of eggs to give. A
lot of eggs. Yeah.
I wanted to build a chicken coop. I literally just talked to my parents about
it. I'll help you. I'll totally tell you how to do it all. She's cute. Isn't this one cute?
Very cute.
She's got like a little haircut.
Yeah, she's got a mohawk.
All right, we're saying goodbye to
this. So that's Dan's three favorite things.
Say goodbye.
And now,
bye.
And now, Kathryn, what are your three must-haves?
Okay, well, obviously, my guitar is
pretty
much number one. All I do is play it all day long. And my second is matching pajamas, which has been a trend for me in the past couple months, but has really, it helps nighttime feel like an activity rather than a sentence.
Like a place to go, an event.
Exactly.
Pace out your day. Yeah.
Exactly. So it really helps. Mm-hmm. And then my phone.
Yeah.
I mean, I've got my Tracy Anderson workouts on here. I've got FaceTimes. I've got everything. It's everything I need in this one little phone.
We never need to leave our houses again, I think is what we've all learned.
Oh, listen, I've been happy.
Well, you know, it's worth acknowledging that we're all, I think, in very sort of privileged positions, that we have a beautiful house to go to. And it's important to recognize that there are a lot of people that don't. And it's a good moment to say a gigantic thank you to our essential workers, the people in the grocery store, stocking the shelves, checking out our groceries, the doctors, the nurses, the garbage men, or garbage people, excuse me, everything. It's so important. And we thank you very much from ACT, from all of us. We're very grateful. So thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. That was a fun segment.
A good segment.
All right. We have like 10 minutes left. So we wanted to find out what all of our favorite cocktails are while we are self-quarantining, while we are in our houses. And this doesn't necessarily have to be an alcoholic beverage.
We like a good mocktail.
We like a good mocktail. And so, yeah, we're curious to know what everybody came up with. Who's first?
So what we call this segment.
Oh, wait, hang on. We call this, you're going to love this one. We call this segment, everybody raise a glass because we're stuck inside the house.
That's brilliant.
So no. Do you get it?
Genius. Master of the house. Duh.
Musical. So
everybody raise a glass because we're stuck inside the house.
Remember I talked about noise-canceling headphones?
Yeah. Now we get it.
I know that Caroline Kellen and Allison Stockel watching this are enjoying it.
I enjoy it.
And probably my sister, Allison Levine. Everybody raise a glass because we're stuck. All right, we're done.
Okay, so I'm going to go first. My cocktail is really complicated. First, you take a glass. Then you take the whiskey bottle. Then you open the whiskey bottle. Then you pour the whiskey in the glass. Ooh. And you're done.
Listening.
That's all I got. That's my cocktail, my quarantine cocktail. And I'm going to have a sip now.
Who's next?
All right, Kathryn, would you share
just every night, like 7 o'clock, this is what I'm dealing with.
Seven? Next?
Huh?
Seven? He waits until seven?
Yeah, I know, right? So Kathryn, yours?
So I've been getting really good at making dirty martinis, which I rarely have out in the world. But I have felt in my silk pajamas, drinking a dirty martini with some olives in it makes me feel so classy. And I've had such a fantasy about like making martinis and like offering them to my guests in my dressing room.
It's never like old world New York. You're like in Peacock Alley in the Waldorf or whatever. Yeah, very fancy.
Oh, that's what I've been doing.
Nice. You're very fancy. Thank you, Kathryn. And Katie?
Well, you've been seeing me drink it.
But what is it?
Okay, so... usually I drink Aperol Spritz, which is delicious, but it involves Prosecco and Aperol. This is Aperol.
Okay, very good.
Uh-huh. And some kind of seltzer. I use an Oris, a sensible orange seltzer.
I know, we like
today I experimented, which maybe tells you a lot about me right now, with doing it with vodka instead of the Prosecco, and it's delish.
Oh,
vodka, Aperol, and seltzer.
Very nice.
Thank you for it.
What'd you say, Kathryn?
Then you don't have to open the whole bottle. It's so smart.
Well, that's been my problem because it's hard to believe, but I can't actually drink an entire bottle of Prosecco in one night. So then I waste it. So then I was like, what can I do to not waste the Prosecco vodka?
Don't forget that at the theater, the Bayolunis gave me that like box of vodka for working opening.
I might run over there.
Just run over there. Yep.
Yeah.
Who's next?
Next we have Daniel.
Oh, me. Well, I am just all about branding. Can you see it?
Mm. Yeah.
It says ACT. But I'm also about just,
plug
like,
it.
Water and like hydrating. And I just feel like one must be, I don't know. I just feel like water is sort of like the cure all. Cheers for
Ready.
Everything. And so I'm just trying to keep hydrated with my water. So that's all. Is Derek next?
Yeah, Derek.
Yeah, I'm all for a low maintenance, no problem drink. What? What's so funny?
He just poured vodka in his water.
Oh. Nice.
Continue, please, Derek. I'm sorry.
I'm all for convenience. So, you know, you have a glass with a little ice in it. And I recently found these amazing canned margaritas There, you know it's fresh when it pops.
Yes.
So, and then you pour it in the glass. Tall boy. And then I like to splash it with just a little bit more of tequila.
You're ready. You're ready for a night in Southern California.
And then you, I prefer mine shaken.
Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, you shake it.
All right, very good. Well, that's everybody
watching
cocktails.
That, wait, hold on, hold on. That's what I call everybody raise a glass because we're stuck inside.
Brian's face.
Playing well, man. Playing well.
Third time's a charm.
Yeah.
I've truly missed your facial expressions. Like, I just need everybody to know that Brian is A, the most brilliant music director. He hears everything. It's honestly terrifying because you can't mess up. And if you think you're in a big group, he knows when you're wrong. And I was often wrong. Yeah, it's freaky. But his face, you don't have to pretend. He was making faces from behind the piano that were just so correct to whatever the vibe was in the room. He would just
correct.
It was correct.
I miss being videoed everywhere in a theater.
Actually, well, Kathryn was talking about Kathryn's fashion tips and like all the stuff that you guys share.
Well, so Kathryn and I have a very special relationship. So I consider Kathryn like my guru to anything that is cool, because I'm inherently not that cool, and I'm totally cool with that. But so every time I bought a new shirt or an outfit or something, I go straight to either Kathryn in rehearsal or Kathryn in her dressing room, and I am desperate for her approval. So, you know, Kathryn, being the style guru that you are, do you have any just, you know, simple quarantine fashion tips to keep, you know, to keep us alive and interesting and, you know, during...
I do. Derek actually recently pointed this out to me that I'm kind of always in quarantine fashion. My go-to shoes for life and quarantine are something that is durable and easy to put on, easy to take off, also with the safety strap in the back. You know, and they're called, yeah, safety first. It's called a Croc. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's my number one shoe of choice since 2007, going strong. So I do wear those every day. I leave them by the door so I can run after my dog when he runs away. My second fashion tip is I like to do a thing where where I wear many kinds of sweatpants, but in the kinds of sweatpants that I wear, I have dark colors and I have light colors. And when I am sad, I wear the bright colors and when I'm happy, I wear the dark colors. So I still feel like my personal life has some variety in it to kind of shake things up. I think that's a huge tip.
Oh, wait, we didn't.
Some people wear many hats. Kathryn wears many sweats.
I don't mean to interrupt this this fashion thing, but what we forgot to do is Kathryn's quarantine fashion tips. Sorry, I had to do
it.
I love
that.
I worked really hard on it, so I needed to put it in there.
It's okay. Really good. And I would guess just say like one final fashion tip would just be to always make sure that whatever you're wearing is comfortable enough to sleep in case a nap happens. Because you don't choose to take a nap, but naps do happen.
So, I have spontaneous naps all the time lately. I say to Dan at like 2 in the afternoon, it's like, no, I could take a nap right now. And he gets like actually angry at me. Like, what?
It's not anger. It's just like, you should still be productive. And I don't know. It's me. I'm just a workaholic, right, Katie?
Yes. Yes, you are.
This is true.
So that was Kathryn's quarantine fashion tips. So next we want to talk to Derek. Derek, you're kind of a newlywed, right? When did you get married?
Almost a year and a half ago. Yeah.
A year and a half ago.
That's newlywed.
September of 2018.
So that's newlywed. Curious to know, we're curious to know what maybe some of your tips are to keep from killing one another during this period of isolation and self-quarantine.
Is it do a live stream
help
together?
Me.
Because that's
totally. Yeah, we've been streaming together. That's how we've kept the cool.
Yeah.
No. Wait, Derek, before you tell us, I just have to tell you that it is, hold on. The little things you do together, Derek's tips for quarantine couples. Okay, go ahead.
I think it's important to do, a little bit of both. it's important to share those times together and be there and do something you enjoy doing together. Like, we love binging TV shows. One recently we binged is Ozark. Mm-hmm. Fantastic TV show. But then on the flip side of things, it's important to have your like alone time. So therefore, headphones to keep my conversations and my music to myself. She's a big reader, so she'll go off and read. But we make sure there's a good balance of both. You do stuff together, and then you make sure to also have your alone time. Tomatoes.
How did she? When you were? I mean, you were contagious. You had it. She didn't get it.
She never showed any symptoms. And I've actually noticed this, and I've heard research done lately that men are being affected a little bit more than females right now. And we've had multiple friends that one couple or like one person in the couple's had it and the other one has it. And there's been tests coming out about blood types. Certain blood types are more susceptible and show symptoms more than others. Alicia must have been, she had to have been a carrier because we co-occupied an apartment for weeks while I was sick, and she never showed symptoms. So that was, she's either a mutant or immune. So
amazing. Amazing. All right, cool. Thanks, Derek. This is Never Have I Ever.
Yeah, we're going to play one last little game, and we're just about to sort of wrap things up here.
But don't worry, we have one more song and then a little video after this game. I'm just saying.
Yes, this is all true. So, all right, we're going to play a little game of Never Have I Ever. And I'm going to, everybody, take a glass. Okay, so this is Never Have I Ever. I'm always so bad at explaining the rules. I'm gonna say a series of statements or questions, and you must drink if you have, in fact, done what I have said.
So we drink if we've done. Oh, wait, I have to show the graphic for this. This is called.
Yeah, I forget more of my.
Never Have I Ever Broadway Edition.
Wow. All
right. Where's Kathryn go?
She's refilling. God. She's refilling because she knows she's going to be drinking.
Kathryn?
I'm just tea tonight. It's super boring.
That's fine. So, all right, everybody. And so make
you
sure
had to you perform. You perform.
Yes. Never have I ever missed an entrance.
Oh.
No. Oh.
Wait. If you have missed an entrance, you drink?
Then you drink.
Derek.
I was going to say.
You're a professional.
Brian was there for it.
Yeah. Yeah. So, okay. This one is very specific for Kathryn and Derek. Never have I ever been yelled at during music rehearsals for not paying attention to the music director.
I get yelled at from a music director every single day.
That's true. All right. Never have I ever laughed during a serious scene on Broadway. Very good. Never have I ever tried to make anyone else laugh on stage.
Okay.
Keep drinking. Here's a good one. Never have I ever stopped singing in a group number because I didn't feel like it that day.
Look who's drinking.
I love how you only pull up hers because she is guilty. So guilty. I've never done that, Brian. So you're welcome.
Here's a good one. Here we go. Three more. Never have I ever hidden behind set pieces or people during rehearsal to avoid being put in a dance number.
Oh.
All right. Two more.
Ain't trying.
Yeah, refill, Kathryn. Refill.
Yeah. I'm already out.
That's a very specific question. Good question.
I know, because I know you. never have I ever altered or adjusted or removed a part of my costume without telling wardrobe department just because I didn't like it.
Ah!
Okay, now last one, and I don't know if, you know, certain people are watching, but never have I ever called out of a show on a Sunday so that I could have an extended weekend.
Oh, very good.
Okay.
Well, yeah.
I
prefer Tuesdays.
That's true. Kathryn is very, very. She's got great attendance.
All right, that was fun.
Yeah, Kathryn, you're the lone survivor, right?
I'm the lone. I'm the only person in Jagged Little Pill that has never called out.
Really?
That's impressive.
Wow, that's amazing.
I know Corona broke my streak.
I know. Well, everybody had to call out, so we're good.
Hey, Derek, Derek recently was at our theater, A.C.T. of Connecticut, here in beautiful Ridgefield, Connecticut.
It's beautiful.
Branding. Derek did our Broadway Unplugged series. So aside from our four main stage shows that we do every season, except for this season where we only did two. Bryan created our Broadway Unplugged series. Bryan, tell us a little bit about Broadway Unplugged.
I mean, just in brief, it's a series I wanted to create just because I get to work with such amazingly talented people who are also just sort of such beautiful, generous humans. I invite them up. We spend some time together and we sing some songs and I ask questions. And it's not just about performing on Broadway, but it's also about, what it's like to be a human in the arts and just a human in general. And we also often talk about why the arts matter so much, why the arts are so essential, and they're essential now more than ever. And Derek and I, we just had such a great concert. People loved it. And it also made me realize how many shows Derek and I have done together. So it was a really fun trip down memory lane. We've had all kinds of performers before. We've had
Lindsay Mendez.
We've had Kate Baldwin, the great Kate Baldwin, who we adore. There's Derek and I. Jessica Vosk and Caitlin Kinnunen were just here.
And
of course, our good friend
Elizabeth Eastlands.
So, we hope to do more of those. And you know, maybe we'll get Kathryn up here to do one sometime. So that'll happen when we reopen. We would love
Kathryn, you have more. To do it.
I'm in.
It's like so fun and it's a great series. It's one of our most popular series. In fact, there's a lady in town that I see is watching the live stream right now because she's commented a little bit. And Derek, I remember, her name is Kathryn Nelligan. And I remember, I don't know if you remember this, Derek, but when you were, after you performed and you came out, you met Kathryn and you turned to me and you said, "Who is that?" Do you remember that?
Yes.
And she,
why do you ask?
Because I told her and she didn't believe me that you said that, that you did say that.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I love Kathryn Nelligan.
Great people. Ridgefield's amazing.
I really hate
that is even.
I hate seeing not being able to see all of my friends.
I know.
It flows. All right. What is next? So that was that. Oh, do you want to do this or no?
I think we probably should keep going.
Oh, so we're going to do a song. We're going to do another song. People want songs. People love music.
All right.
So let's do. So Bryan is going to sing a song. I am moving over. Here I go. I hope I don't lose the connection. So Bryan's going to sing something from Jagged Little Pill. Do you see the piano back there? So that is a piano in Bryan's office here. But we don't, the sound kind of like was bad over there with the setup that we have. So what we have is another keyboard, like literally right here. And I'm showing you here. Let me show you this. Hold on.
Can you see it?
Can you see? So if you see, there's like a piano right here. Can you see it, you guys?
Brilliant.
Yeah.
You can see it.
Cool. So hold on. I want to make sure I'm doing this right. Hold on. Please hold. Please hold. All right. Hold on. I got to get everybody back. How do I do it?
Technology.
All right. There's Kathryn. Oh, God. All right. Why don't you just start the song?
Okay. Very good.
Hold, please.
Okay.
All right. Go.
So I'm going to do my best Sean Krill with love to Sean Krill. And I'm just going to sing a little Mary Jane.
What's the matter, Mary Jane? You had a hard day. As you placed the don't disturb sign on the door, you lost your place in line again. What a pity. You never seem to want to dance anymore. Well, it's full speed, baby, in the wrong direction. There's a few more bruises, if that's the way you insist on heading. So please be honest, Mary Jane, are you happy? Please don't censor your tears. And you're all on your way. Your last grade in a set, and that's why I love you. So take this moment, Mary Jane, and be selfish. Worry not about the cars that go by, 'cause all that matters, Mary Jane, is your freedom. So keep warm, my dear, keep dry. What's the matter, Mary Jane? Tell me, please be honest, Mary Jane. Tell me.
Yeah. Oops, wrong one. Yay. Come on.
Hold there on. We go. You got it.
That was amazing, Bryan.
Thank you.
Amazing.
That was so beautiful.
Kathryn and Derek, did you miss the show watching, listening to that?
Yes. Yeah. And that's the fact that Bryan and I make eye contact. Bryan, when you're on the band platform and I'm hiding behind the wall before, no, we always wave.
Always, every night. We always know how we're feeling that day. It's always, always love. Always so much love. Bryan, you're really talented. Thank you, Daniel.
He is really talented. He's a beautiful boy.
All right. So we've got one more thing to do. Do you want to explain this?
Sure. So we're at the end of our live stream, and we're so thankful that everybody came along the ride with us for this crazy little experiment. And of course, we're very grateful to everyone here. The theater is now closed and we can't, you know, perform any live productions at our theater, we just thought it would be fun to take a quick little trip down memory lane and just share a few highlights of our first two seasons of what we've done so far. So Dan, put together a little video to share with everybody.
All right, so I'm gonna try to get to it. Give me 1 second. I'm muting our other guests. So
lots
muting.
Of technology.
Yep, there we go. Great, now here is the, hold on, I've got to share my screen, and I'm sharing my entire screen. Here we are, so you're going to see that for a second.
See what's going on.
And now we're going to see, hold on, please hold. Now we're going to do this, yep, and now we're going to do this, and these are our sizzle reels from A.C.T, so enjoy this for the next couple minutes. Thank you. How do I get back? Yes. Wait. Okay. Hold on. All right. Good. Are we back? We're back. All right. Did you guys enjoy that? That was, hold on. I'm unmuting all of our guests.
Woohoo.
Wait, hold on. Kathryn, are you there?
Kathryn's here.
Okay, good. Here. Good. So that was, a little compilation of our sizzle reels, our what we've done for the past two seasons, and that's because we can't do any real shows right now until we're starting up our season again in September. Actually, that's when our rehearsals will start, and we'll begin performing once again in October, which seems like a million years away, but it's just happening.
Just the memory of all that beautiful art and those artists and people that created everything it helps me get through it. I just want to say briefly, do you guys have any just sort of closing remarks for everybody? Just a word of encouragement, maybe Kathryn, just a closing statement for everybody.
Yeah, I think that the craziest thing that sort of, you know, I've been going through in my brain this whole time is wrestling between productivity and relaxation and needing to do something, but also not, and like this, and not really understanding how to feel. And so I think the craziest thing for me has been trying to understand that all of that is good. And I know that a lot of people that I've been seeing on the internet have been like really struggling with this idea of what's too much, what's too little. And so I just want to say like this, all these things are weird and unprecedented, and like, to be home and sort of in this situation for so long is insane and can make you feel crazy, and that's okay. So keep going and keep taking it day by day, because that's all I'm doing. And thank you to our first responders. And that's pretty much all that's been on my brain. And
thank you, Kathryn. That's beautiful. How about you, Derek?
Yeah, a couple things. It's weird in our industry because there's so many ups and downs that like when you're not working and the rest of the world is kind of like happening and you feel like this urgency to get back on the horse. This scenario has been different in the way that like, you know, it's been sobering to think that literally the entire world is going through this unprecedented event. Everybody has their hands tied. We're all kind of sitting tight and trying to stay safe and go through this together and be as responsible as possible. So that's a sobering thought that we're literally all in this together. We're literally all at home doing our best to get over this hurdle. So the more that we can do that and support each other, the better. And also, I think going back to our show, and you know, we've all expressed how much we miss our show. And I think coming out of this, when we do, not if, but when we do come out of it, I think the world will be in need of any means to heal. I think, you know, we're going to be so beaten down that we're going to be yearning for people to pick us up and for entertainment to pick us up. And that's one of the beautiful messages of our show, is that, you know, you reach out to one another, you be there to support each other, you look inside yourself, how can you heal, how can you do better, and we'll all do a lot of healing when we come out of this. But just keep staying positive, keep staying hopeful, be safe most of all, and yeah, lots of love to all of you out there still on the front lines fighting this virus, and we'll get through it.
Thanks, Derek.
Thank you, Derek.
Katie?
Oh, gosh. I mean, I think the most amazing thing that we've been able to witness as a community is just how much our community is able to come together, even though we're not be together, but how we're able to really connect and lift up the people who need it. You know, I know there's a lot of there are a lot of people that are making masks for those that need them. You know, I had some sent actually from a friend of mine, a high school friend in Seattle, who was like, does anybody need masks? I will ship them to you. I just, you know, people coming out of the woodwork, wanting to help their community and their friends and their people. Dan actually made a really beautiful video for our first selectman, Rudy Marconi, who has been ill. And it really rallied our whole community to come together and make this video. Dan was so amazing. And just, you know, watching our community try and figure out how to come together and how to lift each other up and how to help the people that need help during this time has been really beautiful to watch. And it's unfortunate that we've had to come together in this way because of this pandemic, but just being able to see people in that light is really moving and interesting. And, you know, I thank our community and our people for being here.
It's great. You know? Good. Am I next? Yeah. Oh, me. Oh God. I don't know. I just want to say that, I say this to Bryan a lot. When Bryan gets upset, that we are all in this together, that everybody's experiencing the same thing, that nobody is alone in this, and that we're just all fighting this together, and we'll also all get through it together. And that theater is going to be changed a little bit and for quite some time. But theater has been here since the beginning of time, and it will be here forever. And we'll get through this, and it's going to be, it's just going to take some time, but we're all in this together. And that's what gets me through, knowing that I'm not alone in this. You know, sometimes I think about like, oh my God, our theater, and what are we going to do? And what's next season going to look like? And blah, blah, blah. And then I look at some smaller theaters that don't have the support that we have, and some people are never going to reopen. And I know that at least we are. Of course, things will be different. But again, we're not alone. We're all in this struggle together. And we'll all come through it together as well. So yeah, that's all I want to say. What about you?
You know, to sort of just piggyback a little bit on what some other people are saying, I know that I certainly have moments where I get very down, very depressed. And what gets me through is going to that piano and just playing and or singing or talking to other, you know, friends. And so with that in mind, one thing I say is find any way you can to support artists and to support the arts, because this is something that it's been interesting to see sort of how some people think it's frivolous. Some people do not think it's essential. And I think our big message is that the arts are essential. And for so many reasons, besides just providing an escape, they shine a big mirror onto us as a society, as a species, onto everything. And what we do matters. So there are so many ways to support artists. One way is to come back. Come back when this is all over and buy tickets if you can. And if you can't, we'll figure that out too. However, whatever, look around, there are artists everywhere. find the opportunity to support artists, find the opportunity to support the arts. And a society that invests in the arts is a society that makes it, as far as I'm concerned. So that is my hope, that is my prayer. And you know, I am so grateful for this evening, and this has been really, really wonderful. So
I wanna thank everybody. I have to just say that like Ridgefield, Connecticut is the best place to live and to open a theater. Katie and I are so grateful and thankful to the people of Ridgefield, Connecticut. I'm grateful to Kathryn and Derek for being the first guests that we have had on this new live stream happy hour. You guys are just like amazing. You're incredible. And we just thank you. And that's it. That was our very, very first live stream of happy hour. Woo-hoo. Kathryn, I love you. I love you. I love you. Yay. Love you, Derek, we love you. We love you.
Love you guys.
I love your mustache even more. Don't stop.
Katie.
Oh, never stop.
We love you. We love you. We love you.
Leave more baked goods at our driveway.
Leave more baked goods at our driveway.
Always,
everybody that's watching, thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting us. For those people that were expecting refunds from Nickel Mines and from Freaky Friday that decided to, instead of getting refunds, donate the price of your tickets to our theater, we thank you. I'm going to cry.
Awesome. Yeah, well, it's a big deal, you know, because we thank you. And just, you know, if we leave you with nothing else, the arts matter. If you have privilege, use your privilege for good. And we remain grateful. And that's what we can do right now. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Ridgefield. Thank you, anybody who watched.
Thank you for being here tonight, you guys. We'll see you soon, okay? Take care. Thanks, Kathryn. Thanks, Derek. Bye, Katie.
Thank you, guys.
Bye.